When I recite any ayat talk about Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, subhanallah, some ayat hit my heart in Surah Al-Baqarah. When he finished to build the Kaaba, him and his son, imagine Ibrahim alayhi salam, his age almost 100, more than 100. And his son Ismail, after he finished the Kaaba, what he said? Yani, mashallah, he did good job and he listened to Allah. But imagine valley without anything. And alayhi salam sent Ismail to bring some stones. After he finished sitting, he said him and Ismail, watub alayna. Why he said that? Imagine Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail, prophet and a messenger, raised their hands and said, watub alayna. The best human said that. Imagine me and you. We always we need ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, grant us repentance. We need repentance every second of our life. For the best human in their time, Prophet Ibrahim and Ismail did that. And alayhi salatu wasalam, one day he sat down in the masjid, and one companion came to him and said, oh, our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, my father passed away, and he need to go to Hajj. And alayhi salatu wasalam said, you must go to make Hajj and Umrah. Behave your father. Why alayhi salatu wasalam commands the companion must make Hajj and Umrah? And unfortunately here I know some people, every year some sister called me, please call my husband, I want to go to Hajj. I marry him 30 years and you have money, you have everything, alhamdulillah, our health is good, our wealth is good. But unfortunately my husband, he don't want to go. But I want to go. Imagine the sister, mashallah, she want to go to Hajj. She believe Hajj 100%. If you go to Hajj, think of Allah. If you go to Hajj, say labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. Wow, all the word in Hajj is tawheed. Against any politics, people bring, only we have one God. God control us. We try follow command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah accepts your Hajj, you come back as a baby, as new baby. Imagine why you need to go. Take advantage from your age. Suddenly so and so passed away. Suddenly so and so has disease, he can't move now. We have a lot of brothers around us, a lot of sisters, has disease, they can't go, like, and he can't walk. So, alhamdulillah, if Allah give you ability to walk, to alhamdulillah, remember Allah, go to Hajj. Think of Allah, then for yourself, the obligation upon us. Okay, one of pillar of Islam. When Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam finished to build the Kaaba, and Allah commanded him, now make adhan to the people to come to make Hajj. And imagine he stand up in desert. He said, how come? We are in desert. If he make adhan, not anyone listen to him. And Allah said, okay, don't worry. Make adhan, I would convey to everyone. Imagine now if you go to Hajj, may Allah help anyone to go, you will see people from all the world. Okay? From Argentina, from Brazil, from USA, from Europe, Pakistan, India, Arab, non-Arab. Wow, and everyone came, wear clothes, very simple clothes, as a kafan, as your kafan. Okay? Not in the fancy. Maybe you fancy your hotel, your something is not work. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially the day of Arafah, Allah looked to your heart. When you stand up, especially last 2 hours in Arafat, when you stand up, raise your hand and cry. Why you went there, sacrifice your time, your money, your everything, and you stand up in very bad weather, and you cry to Allah. Why? To protect you from the fire. To put you, us inshallah, in paradise. But please encourage yourself first, then encourage your colleague, your relative, anyone. Go to Hajj, seek of Allah. Go and prepare your attention. Maybe next year come, we're not alive. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to mention him as Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. May Allah make the Quran and the Sunnah benefit to us in our life and hereafter. Jazakumullah khair.